Mr. Speaker, I rise today to honor a civil rights hero, Rosa Parks, who's best known for taking a stand by refusing to stand. My resolution designates February the 4th, the day of her birth, as Rosa Parks Remembrance Day here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. At age 42, she refused to give up her seat to a white man on a city bus in Montgomery, Alabama. In some tellings of the story, people say that she was tired at the end of her workday. Mrs. Parks said it a little bit differently. She said, "The only tired I was tired of giving in." She also later said that the murder victim, Emmett Till, was on her mind when she refused to give up her seat. Mrs. Parks was arrested. She lost her job on December the 1st, 1955. A 381-day bus boycott began on December the 5th of 1955, and it lasted until December 20th of 1956. This boycott is often known as the spark to the civil rights movement in America, and it was very successful. The bus system was later integrated by law. Rosa Parks had already been a very active member in the civil rights movement long before that. In fact, she continued to do so long afterward. For example, she fought against housing discrimination in Detroit, and she also traveled nationally to support efforts such as the Selma to Montgomery marches. She inspired countless civil rights activists in her lifetime, and she continues to inspire today. I'm encouraged to know that one woman, moved by faith, conviction, and bravery, can change the course of history. Upon her death in 2005, Mrs. Parks became the first woman in the United States history to lie in honor at the United States Capitol Rotunda. I thank my colleagues in joining me in recognizing Rosa Parks Remembrance Day here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and I thank the members of the Pennsylvania Legislative Black Caucus for joining me as well. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.